Microorganisms used for industrial applications ranges from bacteria, fungi, algae, and viruses. Various bacteria are useful in the production of chemicals, enzymes, and fermentation, like Clostridium acetobacillicum, using the production of ethanol with riboflavin as a byproduct. Various lactic acid bacteria are used in lactic acid fermentation and production of yogurt and other useful products. Fungi, various yeasts and molds also are used in the industry. For instance, various Saccharomyces species are used either for production of beer and wine, or even production of bread. Or yeast biomass, which is useful and of industrial application. Some molds also have industrial application for production of various enzymes and chemicals. For example, aspartic acid can be used for production of citric acid. And various enzymes are produced using molds. Algae are also useful for production of food colorants, dyes, omega-3 fatty acids, and even cosmetics. And viruses are useful for production of vaccines, carriers, and useful in gene therapy. To be useful in an industrial process, it usually will have some attributes which will make it amenable to industrial manipulations. These attributes are very necessary when considering any microorganism as an input in an industrial process. Namely, one, the organism must be able to grow in simple medium and should preferably not require growth factors. Here, warming growth factors, we are talking about things like preformed vitamins, nucleotides, and acids, which are outside those that may be present in industrial medium which it is grown. Secondly, the organism should be able to grow vigorously and rapidly in the medium under use. A slow-growing organism, no matter how efficient it is, in terms of the production, could be a liability. Because industrial processes are capital ventures and run on the model of capitalism. The essence is to make gain. The end product should also not include toxic and other undesirable materials, especially if the products are for human and animal consumption. The organism should have a reasonable genetic and biological stability, because if an organism mutates easily, it poses an expensive risk. And that mutation may result to production of different end products, which is not very good for an industrial setting. The organism should lend itself to a suitable method of product harvest at the end of the process. In beer production, we talk about bottom fermenters and top fermenters, which is dependent on the flocculation of the yeast, whether the yeast flocculates on top or settles at the bottom. And this makes it easy for separation of the product, which is beer, from the yeast. The in addition, the organism should have a physiological requirement which protects them against competition from contaminants. Sometimes contaminants may enter the industrial system and may outcompete the organisms for production. Organisms with optimum productivity at high temperature, low pH values, and are capable of elaborating agents inhibiting to competitors have added advantage over others. The organism should also be reasonably resistant to predators such as bacteriophages. In addition, the organism should not demand oxygen too highly because aeration contributes about 20% of the cost of products during aerobic fermentation. So aeration could be very costly if the organism demands oxygen too highly. Lastly, the organism should be easily amenable to genetic manipulations to induce the establishment of strains with more acceptable properties. In fact, you see from all these characteristics that it may be difficult to pin down any organism to have all these characteristics, but some organisms will have most of these characteristics and are therefore suitable for application in industrial settings. However, with modern biotechnology and genetic engineering, organisms are usually manipulated to suit the industrial setting and process, and the process technology and product development for that protocol, such that some of these things are put under control for efficient production process.